Elliot from Spaghetti Lab back again, and in today's video we're going to talk about how to upload code to the Arduino. Now this might be useful for someone who is having trouble uploading code to the Arduino, but also someone who hasn't used it before because they can get a sense for what's actually going on with this type of device. Also, if you haven't been doing a lot of research in this area for a long time, this video is actually going to show you a newer tool for uploading code, which is called Arduino Create, and it's a website for doing that. So I'm going to show you both tools and we're going to jump into the computer now. Okay, so this process begins at the Arduino website. This is arduino.cc, and you can actually read up here on the latest boards that the Arduino Foundation is making. There's community resources, all kinds of stuff. And we're going to go to the software page, and here are the two options. So there is the online IDE, and that's IDE stands for Integrated Development Environment, and I'll explain that in a second. And then here is the downloadable IDE, and you can see it's for Windows, Mac, and Linux. So I recommend the downloadable one is the kind of de facto standard, and I like it, but the web editor has some really cool tools as well. So I'm going to show you the Arduino IDE, and here it is, and here's some code that I have. So I have the Arduino board in my hand, unplugged. So the basic sketch is Blink, and this one is like your Hello World, which is a classic programming kind of starter program. And this is a good one to check if the Arduino is uploading properly. And I'm going to plug in my Arduino. Make sure you snap it in really well. And the other side's plugged into my MacBook. And I'm going to go up to Tools, and I'm going to check that the board is the Uno. And you can see some of the other boards here. They all have different specifications for how it's going to upload. And I'm also making sure that this USB modem 1421 is active. And if you don't see the 1421 doesn't really matter. It's the USB modem port. And if you don't see that, you might be using a different type of Arduino that requires more drivers to be installed, and I can do a whole other video on that. This one is the I showed you in a previous video with the chip that's soldered on. That's the CH chip. This one would need a driver installed, and it wouldn't show up in this list of serial ports if I didn't install those drivers. Otherwise, I'm not going to worry about too much stuff here. This button right here uploads the code to the device, and it also does a check on the code before it uploads it to make sure that all the code is correct. So you can see it's compiling the sketch, and if everything goes well, it's going to successfully upload it. So this sketch, I know this one worked properly because orange LED light is blinking on the device, and we're going to show you how to actually make that blink a real LED light in the next video. And very quickly, it's running a loop over here, and it's 1 second is going to be on. That's 1,000 milliseconds. And 1,000 milliseconds, it's gonna go off. And that's all this program does. Okay, so the second way to upload code to the Arduino is through the Arduino Create software. And something to keep in mind is if I was running the standalone application, I'd want to close that before playing around with the web interface. And also, this does involve a piece of software in the installed in the operating system called the debug console. It's sort of a plugin that runs at the top, and if that's out of date, you're going to have trouble uploading to the web editor. Now, I'm already signed in, and I've already installed that plugin into the system. Kind of speeds things up a bit. And I'm now into the editor. So I'm going to go into the examples on the left side of the page, basics, blink, and it connected to my Uno on the USB modem port, and I'm going to upload it. It's verifying it, uploading, and it worked. Now I already had Blink uploaded to the board before, so let's check that it did it properly by adjusting the milliseconds to 100. Re-verifying, and now the board is blinking a lot faster. So these were the two ways to upload it. There might be a whole bunch of other types of tools out there, but these are two good ones. And just something from before that I maybe didn't mention, the IDE, Integrated Development Environment, that kind of helps check the code. And there's all kinds of IDEs out there, but not all of them are set up to upload specifically to the Arduino.